Pauline Hanson's right-hand man James Ashby might find himself banned from Parliament House for even longer as an investigation examines his role in the scuffle inside the building. Let's go live to our political reporter Jonathan Kersley. Jono, good morning. For now, Mr. Ashby has left the building.
That's right, Davina. Pauline Hanson's Chief of Staff, James Ashby, flew home last night to Brisbane. He won't be allowed back inside Parliament House here in Canberra for some time. Yesterday, Senate President Scott Ryan revoked Mr. Ashby's pass following that dust-up with former One Nation turned United Australia Party Senator Brian Burston. In that footage, Mr. Ashby appeared to confront the senator, then film the altercation that followed. This incident was sparked by sexual harassment claims from Senator Burston levelled at Senator Hanson, who herself, a day earlier, had claimed there was a married senator who had sexual harassment allegations levelled at him. Now, Mr. Ashby's ban could be extended if more information on this incident comes to light. Part of the investigation will involve looking at more CCTV footage from inside Parliament House. And while there's plenty of attention focused on Senator Hanson's Chief of Staff, there's questions too around the actions of Senator Burston, who yesterday admitted smearing blood on his former party leader's office door.
Will the government still be accepting or prepared to accept Brian Burston's vote in the Senate?
Well, you know, I think we need votes on critical legislation and we don't really mind where they come from.
This is something that requires some form of attention by authorities because you don't expect people to be assaulting each other in any workplace.
The most bizarre thing from my assessment of it is the idea a senator would be smearing his own blood on the office door of another senator. This Burston couldn't be the full quid.
Meanwhile, almost 6 months since the coup against Malcolm Turnbull, and it's been known he's been writing a book. Now there's a release date for the memoirs, titled Malcolm Turnbull, an Autobiography. It'll be sold globally from late this year, Davina, maybe just in time for Christmas.
Just after the election, hopefully. Jono, we'll leave it there. Thank you.